Nikki Glossman, Kathy Doolittle, and Kevin Clancy. The one who fares the best could drive off in this Bronco 2 4x4. And now, here's your host, the star of Wipeout, Peter Tomarkin.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Hi, thank you, Jim Hackett. Hi, everybody, and welcome once again to another episode of Wipeout. You know what I mean? We're going to have a lot of fun here today. You folks at home can play along. And as far as the three contestants are concerned, well, one of them and only one will get a chance to drive off in a brand new car. So, not too shabby. Let's talk to him right now. We have Nikki with us. And Nikki, you are from Sacramento?
From Sacramento, that's right.
What do you do up there?
Well, right now I have a family and I have a four-year-old daughter.
You're a busy lady.
She keeps me busy. And in my spare time, I do various different things for social and...
Great. Well, nice of you to stop by here and play the game.
Well, thank you.
Good luck.
Thank you.
All right, we have Kathy with us. And Kathy, what is this? You're married to Dr. Doolittle?
Yes.
What is it?
I am. I'm married to Dr. Doolittle. Yeah. It's a new adventure every day. And I must say that Dr. Doolittle is a Bruin.
A Bruin. All right,
he's
a Bruin.
UCLA and alumni.
Me too. So you knew that's why you did it. But you've also been kissed by Shamu, so you haven't been totally faithful, right?
Well,
let's get it out here. Let's get
he
it out. It's like
me.
The Oprah show.
What do I do?
Get it out in the open and we'll talk about it. You feel better now that you've kind of confessed?
I feel relieved.
Good. All right. Now we'll play the game. Right. And we have Kevin with us.
Yeah.
How are you, Kevin?
Me too.
Wow, you're frightened. Oh, that's your normal hair. I didn't know. But you're all uptight. You're a baseball player,
yeah.
I understand.
Yeah,
what happened? Did you get something good happen to you in the last day or so?
Yes. As a matter of fact, yesterday I got a baseball scholarship to Cal State in the field.
Great. Yeah. Well, we look forward to seeing you in the big league. All right. Right now, Big Leagues game show. You ready?
Right.
Let's do it. All right, gang. 16 answers on our board. 11 of them will be correct. 5 of them will not be. Your job to find the 11 correct answers, with the first one worth $25. That second correct answer is then worth $50 and $75 and so on until 11th correct answer is worth $275. That translates to a little bit of strategy. Also, if you're wrong, we don't do anything physical to you. We just lay a wipeout on you, which means you lose your money and your turn. You don't want that to happen because only two of you will make it on to the challenge round. That guy or girl in third place is going to be unhappy about that. But that's the way the game plays, all right? Nikki, you drew first position, so you get first crack at the board. You can pass if you so desire, but you must make at least one selection before you pass. Should we look at the board? Why not? Let's see it. All right. Which 11 of these are facts about Marilyn Monroe? Nikki, give me one, and it's worth $25 for starters.
I'm going to start with her debut in The Seven-Year Itch.
Debut in Seven-Year Itch. Let's find out. She had small parts earlier. It was not a debut. It has one whammy. Whammy, I finally said it. I knew I would say it. It's all right. I feel better that it's out of my system. It's gone. And now, do you want to press your luck or do you want to move on? No, I get it all out of my system. You're up, Kathy. There are 11 correct answers still, only 4 wipeouts.
Okay. I think that Marilyn married Joe DiMaggio.
Let's find out about Marilyn. Joe DiMaggio is right. You have $25. Good start. 10 correct left. You want to keep going or pass on to Kevin?
Yes. I'd
right.
like to go on.
Give me an answer.
Oscar nod for bus stop.
Oscar nod for bus stop. Let's find out. Not there. Take your 25 away and go to Kevin. 3 wipeouts, 10 correct answers left, Kevin. Worth $50 if you're right.
Let's go with it. In more than 25 films.
In more than 25 films, we'll find out. Yes, indeed, Marilyn was. Marilyn was in 29 of them, to be exact. 9 correct answers left, Kevin. You have $50. You going to play on?
Yes, I'm going to play on.
Okay.
Let's go with Marilyn would be 62 now.
All right, find out if Marilyn Monroe would be 62 now. Yes, she would. Boy, you're a Marilyn Monroe buff, Kevin. 8 correct left. You have $125.
How many are correct?
8 correct, 3 wipeouts.
Let's keep on going. Let's go on. Okay.
Got to have an answer.
She was Nebraska born.
Was she Nebraska born? Let's find out if Marilyn Monroe was born in Nebraska. Marilyn Monroe was born in Los Angeles. 2 wipeouts left. We go to Nikki. 8 correct answers. The odds are tremendous. Worth $100 if you're right, Nikki.
How about married at 16?
Married at 16. Let's find out. Yep, to a 21-year-old aircraft worker. You have $100. 7 correct answers left, Nikki. What What do you want to do?
I might as well go with the odds. Born illegitimate.
Was Marilyn Monroe born illegitimate? Let's find out. Yes, she was. That's 225. Six correct left, two wipeouts. You can keep going or pass to Kathy.
I'm going to go ahead and go with the odds again and say Mom was an actress.
Was Mom an actress? Let's see if Marilyn Monroe's mother was an actress. Was not. She was a film cutter. Hey, gang, nobody has any money, but we're having a lot of fun. Kathy, it's to you. Six correct. There's only one wipeout left. Six of them are correct. You're in great shape.
Okay.
$150 is the worth of the answer if it is correct.
Co-starred with Sir Laurence Olivier.
Co-starred with Sir Laurence Olivier. Did Marilyn Monroe do that? Yes, she did. The Prince and the Showgirl. You have $150. There are five correct. One wipeout. $175 if you're right. You can pass or play.
I'll play.
Okay, here we go.
Worked as a spray painter.
Let's find out if you worked as a spray painter. Yes, she did at the age of 18. And Kathy's up to 325. Four correct, one wipeout. 420, 325, rather. You want to pass to Kevin or keep going? Got to have an answer, Kathy.
I'll play.
Play. Here we go. Pick one or four correct.
Converted to Judaism.
Did she convert to Judaism? Yes, she did when she married Arthur Miller. You're now up to 525, Kathy. Three correct. Pass to Kevin. Kevin, one wipeout left. Three correct.
Monroe, Mom's surname.
Monroe, Mom's surname. Is that Mom's surname? Yeah. Whoa, you got it. You got $225 and the old hotspot. What's on the hotspot today, Big Jim?
Well, hotspot winner will enjoy one of the nicest spots in Palm Springs, the Oasis Water Resort Villa Hotel, near Bing Canyon Drive Shopping. Plus, admission each day to the water resort with one of California's largest wave-action pools, valued at over $1,200.
Whoa! P.S. I love you, says Kevin. There it is. That's yours. The object is to hold on to it, Kevin, because should you wipe out during the round, it goes up on the board, back behind another correct answer for someone else to grab. You also have to be one of the two players to move on to the challenge round in order to keep it. And hey, who knows? Maybe you get a tryout with the Angels down there, you know?
Yeah.
All right, you have $225. You're in second position. There are two correct, one wipeout.
I'm going to play.
You're going to play? All right, here we go.
Marilyn had her own film company.
Did she have her own film company?
Yes,
let's find out. Marilyn Monroe did. Kevin. 475, you're in second place. 1-1.
No, I'm gonna play.
All right, let me tell you what happens. If you wipe out, you're gonna lose the hot spot, and we'll have a tie with you and Nikki. If you're right on this, you will go to the challenge round with Kathy. Are you ready? One correct and one wipe out. Give me your choice.
Pose for new calendar.
We're gonna find out if Marilyn posed for the new calendar. Unemployed in the 1930s. And we have Nikki, no dollars, Kathy, $525, Kevin, $750, and a dancer, no less. That means Kathy and Kevin are going on to the challenge round. Congratulations, Nikki. Got some nice prizes for you.
Thank you.
It was a great game.
Much.
And we'll be back with a challenge round, which I hope is half as exciting as this was after these games. Challenge round, Kathy and Kevin. Boy, you guys, that was a great game. Kathy has $525, Kevin, $750, plus the hot spot. And we're going to put all that money in a nice, safe place. Oh! Star Trek invaded us and takes our money. All right, Jim, tell them what they're playing for in the challenge round.
Yes, sir. The second round winner will be off to Florida to stay at Saddlebrook. Enjoy two golf courses, 37 tennis courts, swimming, house spa, fine dining, and luxurious accommodations. Tampa Bay's great golf and tennis resort will fly you and a companion from Los Angeles to Tampa aboard Delta Airlines. Award-winning service. You'll also experience exclusive Crown Room Lounge in the new Oasis Terminal, all from Delta Airlines. The retail value of this trip, Peter, is over $2,700.
All right, Tampa. Sounds pretty good to me. I'll tell you how you can get it. Very simple. We're going to put up a board with 12 answers. Eight will be correct. Four will be wipeouts. You don't want any part of the wipeouts, obviously. We're going to pit the two of you against one another. That's the kind of people we are, you know? We are going to put the two of you against one another. The first of you wins two boards, then gets the trip to Tampa Bay and gets to stop by and check out the bonus, all right? And what I'm going to do is go to Kevin first, because he won the most money in round one, and ask him how many he can get right on our famous board without wiping out. I will then go to Kathy to ask if she wants to increase the bid or call Kevin on his bid. We'll go back and forth until we get to the maximum number of eight or until one of you challenges the other. Once that player is challenged, he or she must give me all the answers they did correctly in a row, or the other player can jump in and only answer one correctly for a win. Everybody understand that? Let us look at the old board, and Kevin, you're up. The Book of Lists tells us 8 of these words are the most commonly used in written English. How many can you come up with without wiping out, Kevin? There are 8 correct.
I can come up with 5.
5. Over to Kathy. You want to increase the bid? It's 5. Kathy, or 5?
I'm going to challenge.
Challenge? 5. She doesn't think you can do it, Kevin. Well, we'll show her.
I have the audience.
Nobody, any of it. Do you think you can do it?
Yeah!
Kevin, they have confidence in you. After all, you do speak it. It is English. All right. Give me 5 in a row. If you do that, you'll win the first board, and if you slip up, then Kathy gets to jump in. Remember, written English, 5 in a row. Here we go.
Let's go with the.
The. Let's find out if that is the one of the big written English words. It is. 4. 4 to go, Kevin.
Let's go with and.
Is that a commonly written English word? Yes, it is. It's the 8. 3 to go, Kevin.
I need 3 more, right, Peter?
Yeah. Gotta give me 1 right now.
Let's go with A.
A, is that a commonly written English word? Yes, 7. 2 to go, Kevin. You're on a roll.
Let's go with with.
With. With. Is with one of the commonly used written English words? No, it is not. That means we go over to Kathy, and this is what you've been waiting for, Kathy, a chance to jump in. Give me 1 right answer. There are 5. All I need is 1, and you win the board.
I'm going to say 2.
2. Is 2 a commonly written? Yes, it is. It is 6, and you did it, Kathy. You jumped in and got it. You stole away from Kevin. Let's look at the other commonly used written English words. They are you, which is the first, and is second most used of the third. In is the 6th most commonly used, and those are the correct answers. And when we come back, Kathy, you only need 1 game. Kevin, you'll need 2, but I know the kind of guy you are. You can come from behind. We're coming back for the last half of the challenge round after these words. Don't go away.
Now, more of Wipeout.
All right, second half of the challenge round. Here we are. Kathy has, as we're 1 in the bag, right, Kevin? Nothing for you. But, Kathy, you're up, as a matter of fact.
Okay.
Are you ready for the second board?
Yes.
Because here it comes.
Okay.
All right, 8 of these cities are on one of the Great Lakes. How many can you name without wiping out, Kathy? There are 8 correct.
3. 3.
Over to you, Kevin. How many can you do? Can you increase that bid, or are you going to call her on 3?
Let's go with 5.
5. Kevin has thrown down the gauntlet. Kathy?
Kevin, name those cities.
Kevin, got him. All right, 5 in a row, Kevin. If you do it, you'll tie it up. If not, Kathy gets to jump in. You don't want that to happen. There are 8 correct. Give me 5 in a row. 8 cities are... You just bid. What do you care? The correct question was, how many of these are spelled back? No, no. 8 of these cities are on one of the Great Lakes. Name them. Give me 5 in a row.
Let's go with... Ottawa.
Let's go with Ottawa and find out if it's on one of the Great Lakes. I would say an inauspicious beginning, Kevin. There are 8 correct still, Kathy. All you have to do, I'll repeat it, because we'll have a lot of time now, is for you to give me 1 correct answer out of the 8, and you'll win the board. You'll get the trip to Tampa Bay, and we'll talk about bonus. All right? I need 1. There are 8.
Erie.
Let's find out if Erie is on one of the Great Lakes. Yeah! It sure is, and wow, you got it. What a good sport. That's great. Kevin, let us together look at the other correct answers. Let's find out. Toledo's on one of the Great Lakes, as well as Toronto, and Thunder Bay, Green Bay, Duluth, Niagara Falls, and Buffalo, all of them on a Great Lake. I'm sure, Kevin, you will never forget. Yours wasn't, not Ottawa, but Kevin... Hey, this is not chopped liver here. We're talking $750 and leaving with us, plus that hotspot trip to Palm Springs for a total of $1,953.
Yeah.
And good luck in baseball. All right, it's been a real pleasure to have with us. And Kathy, you're going to Tampa Bay. Come on over here. Because before you go there, we're talking about a new car. And we're coming back to show that car after these words. Stay with us. We'll
there's more excitement on Wipeout.
All right, we're back with Kathy. She made it all the way to the bonus round. And what is this Blue Thunder? What's Blue Thunder?
That's my car. BT, for short.
15 years old?
Yes, 15
well,
years old.
Well, we got something. We call it Red Thunder, and it's brand new.
Oh.
Check this out.
Kathy, it's the new Ford Bronco 2 4x4. An easy handling on and off-road vehicle, both sporty and comfortable. Built for single spot or a family outing from Walker Burkey Ford.
Whoa! That'll beat Blue Thunder anytime, won't it?
I think so.
Okay, let me show you how easy it is to win.
Okay.
We're going to give you a question and then put 12 answers on the board. Six of the answers will be right, six will be wrong. You find the six correct ones, and you can say goodbye to Blue Thunder, all right? Let me show you how. We'll give myself a category. Famous dwarfs. There's the 12. For me, I'm going to want to pick the six I think are correct. I do that by getting over here, touching the rim around the TV, I believe, has the right answer. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7 won't do me any good, so I'm going to come back here, hit the old buzzer and see how I did. I got 3. I want 6. So I'm going to make some changes. In order to do that, I have to find something I'm not sure of and turn that off before I can make a new selection. So I don't think Fatty's right. I think it's Sleepy. Let's see if that improves what I did. And I'll come over here and hit it again. And I'm up at 4. Wow. I keep doing it until I got them all right. And then I would have you still be sitting around with Blue Thunder, which is not what you want. All right? We're going to give you your own category and 60 seconds within which to do it. Are you ready?
Yes.
Let's look at your answers. 6 of these are Beatles songs that hit the number one in the United States. Can you name them? They hit number one. Can you name them? Are you ready? 60 seconds.
Yes.
Good luck. Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's see how you did. 3. 48 seconds. Plenty of time, Kathy. All right. Let's see how you did with that. 38 seconds. 4, that's an improvement. 35 seconds. 29 seconds, you're only halfway. 5! Come on, Kathy, you got 25 seconds to get that 6. Let's see if that does it. 4, you want to go? You want to go back? 15, 14 seconds, 13, 12, 10, 9, 8, 7, 4, 5 seconds, 4, 3, come on back, 3, 2 seconds, 1, oh, no more time, oh, you were so close, let's see the correct answers, please. Help, Get Back, Ticket to Ride, Hey Jude, Love Me Do, and Let It Be. You had, what, you had 4, or
five,
you had 4, you had 5 at one time, wow, how about, you want me to sing all these?
Would you? I could
last
you sing
time,
a rendition of Get Back?
Do you want me to sing a rendition of that? Last time I sang, we had to get Barry Manilow in the car. I won't do any of that, but we'll be back after these words. Stay with us.
If you would like to be a contestant on Wipeout and plan to be in the Los Angeles area sometime in the near future, come on, give us a call on our Wipeout contestant hotline at area code 213-463-0161, weekdays 9 to 5 Pacific time. Now, let's return to Wipeout and Peter Tomarkin.
And we're back with Kathy, who got ever so close. But what the heck, Blue Thunder's okay, it lasted this long, right?
Right.
You got your trip to Tampa Bay, as well as the cash in round one, for a grand total of $3,245.
I'm happy.
Yeah, Tampa Bay, you'll love it. It's a great place to go. You have, there's a lot of sports for your husband there. You'll have a good time basking in the sun. It is a nice, nice place. And I expect you will forever remember the number one songs of the Beatles, right?
I think I will.
You got real close, so you knew them pretty, you were pretty hot, I got to tell you. Well, I'll tell you, we're coming back next time. Of course, Kathy's going to Tampa Bay. I send everybody everywhere, and I just, well, I kind of stay here. Until next time, Peter Tomarkin, bye-bye for Wipeout. Thank you.
Some member of our studio audience may receive White Westinghouse's family-size 17-cubic-foot frost-free refrigerator freezer with chilled meatkeeper compartment, cantilever shelves, and glide-out rollers from White Westinghouse. If you would like to see Wipeout in person, plan to attend a taping session here in Hollywood by calling for ticket information at area code 213-468-5575 weekdays. Some of our departing contestants will receive salon-formulated Germax Silver Shampoo and Conditioner. Tones down brassiness, enhances shine in gray, graying, or frosted hair. And Color Sense by Ruffies. Now there's a plastic bag in your choice of today's fashionable colors with matching deodorizing scents. Color Sense from Polytech. And 6 quarts of quality TruTest XO Rust products to beautify and protect metal from True Value Hardware stores and home centers. And Orifix Special Denture Adhesive. Worried about loose dentures? Orifix holds them tight day and night. Orifix them. That'll fix them. The fun can't be beat as Wink Martindale.
It wasn't.